I'm Francesco Fantini and I'm talking to you all the history of Fabriano. History of art of Fabriano from 13th century to our area. The master of Campodonico is one of the most important artists of our history. 13th century, as you know, was the influence of Umbria and Tuscany, Giotto picture. The drawing, as you know, is a fresco, is now at the Art Gallery of Fabriano, and it's very impact because you can see crucifixion with dramatic scene and a lot of apostles. San Giovanni Evangelista, San Johannes Evangelist, and the blue as background that is very particular experience, pathos and very, very emotional painting. Master of Campodonico, now you can see the Annunciation from the Virgin and the Angel. And it's very, very particular because you can see massive bodies, bulk bodies, very, very strong, very hard. And you can see a typical picture of this part of Apennine between Tuscany and the Adriatic Sea. We are in Fabriano, and all this cycle of frescoes were in San Biagio in Caprile, but now you can find them at our gallery in Fabriano. The Crucifixion is very intense, is very strong, and as you know, every time you find this blue background that can adapt to the frescoes, important cycle. Very, very important master. We don't know his name because he's unknown, but we call him the master of Campodonico for the location where he worked. The master of Campodonico was an important painter, one of the first important painters of this influence from Tuscany and Umbria. And a lot of other painters from Fabriano, as Allegretto di Nuzio, Allegretto Nuzi, went to his influence. For example, you can see the art of a great painter of the 14th century, Allegretto Nuzi. This is the Magdalene Penitent, the Magdalene with red cloth. And you can see the particular heart of Allegretto. Particular because he uses primitive and, as you know, and very intense colors. And he works in the gold. The Magdalene was a part of this polyptych. Polyptych that is now in our art gallery in Fabriano. You know, you can see a lot of saints, Magdalene, San Giovanni Evangelista, Evangelic San Johannes, San Bartholomew with a knife, and at the end with the flag, white and red, San Venanzio. This polyptych is in our art gallery in Fabriano. Allegretto Nuzzi, medieval painter, you can see the particular in this, for example, in this fresco, you see the Emperor Decio. It's the cycle of the death, the flagellation, and also the death of Saint Lawrence. This cycle is in San Venanzio. behind the chorus. The particular faces, particular clothes, particular, you see all these figures very, very steady, but you can see also the particular art of an important artist that had influence not only from master of Campodonico, but from masters from Florence, Bernardo Daddi, Maso di Banco, Orcagno, the great paintings in Florence, where he went to work and where he went to live. Flagellation of Saint Laurence is very intense, but you can see the colors, you can see the clothes, the dresses in medieval age. Allegretto Nuzzi was one of the most important masters, and he learned a lot of arts in Florence, and the influence, as you know, from the master of Campodonico. The flagellation of Saint Laurence is intense, is the martyrdom of the saint. His most abilities are the clothes, are the dresses. You can see the particulars. He works very well in the clothes, in the details of the clothes. You can see turtles, parrots, animals in the clothes and the dresses. The ability is very, very high. And he learned this art in Florence when he had relationships with silks, with clothes, with the dresses, with the markets from Lucca, from other cities in Florence. So he learned this art to work and to paint the clothes. The particular are very, very, very beautiful. This cloth is of St. Stephen in the Polyptych, in triptych, in the Art Gallery in Fabriano. Allegretto Nuzzi and St. Johannes Baptist is the saint of Fabriano, and San Venanzio with the flag, red and white, is a part of an important polyptych that was found in Santa Maria dell'Appennino, St. Mary in the Apennines, an old abbey close to Fabriano. Now is at the Museum of Church, Museum Diocesano in Fabriano. Allegretto Nuzzi made an important cycle in San Dominic for Dominicans, and is a cycle of Sant'Ursula, the saint that with the Virgin made a long, long trip and was dead and was killed by Attila, the king of Uni, the important king of the Eastern Europe. The cycle is very, very important. It's in San Dominic, so you can visit it in this beautiful church, important church, in the center of Fabriano. It's very florid, because you can see also an art of master of wise men, maestro dei magi. And Allegretto Nuzio did an important work by decorating all these wooden statues. It's a decoration, but the art of wood is from Bartolomeo, maestro dei magi, master of the wise men. This statue is in the Art Gallery in Fabriano. An important artist close to Allegretto di Nuzio is Puccio di Simone, is Sant'Antonio Abate, Saint Anthony Abbot, is a very, very impressive, very strong, because is a saint that was so important religion in that period, in the 14th, and he met him in Florence, and there was important, a big cooperation from Allegretto and Puccio di Simone. This is a particular of this painting of Puccio di Simone, are the boats, in particular the part of men, soldiers. You can see also the clothes, the dresses, medieval. The art of Puccio di Simone was in Fabriano when he went here with Allegretto di Nuzio for the cooperation. And now I will talk about Gentile da Fabriano, the most important painter of the period from the last part 14th century and half part of 5th century. We don't have a masterpiece in Fabriano, but it was so important that I can fast explain to you some masterpiece. This is the Adoration of Wise Men. It's a great masterpiece at Uffizi in Florence. You can see the gold, you can see the details. And on the left, from the Wise Men, you can see the portrait of the son of Commitment, Strozzi, Lorenzo Strozzi, the son of the lord of the family. Gentile was really master. And the Adoration of Magi in Florence at Uffizi is the masterpiece of the room of 14th century and the 15th century, because it was dated 14 and 23. It's wonderful. For details, for animals, for vegetables, gepards, horses, a close, a big procession of the family Strozzi. The detail are the cavaliers, dogs, greyhounds, monkeys, all the typical animals, all the typical members, all the typical persons of a procession of the Middle Ages. It's very particular, it's in Florence now. It's a typical Madonna Virgin with a child. It's in Perugia. He did this masterpiece for Dominicans. In Perugia, you can see the gold. The gold is fundamental in his art. The background of this great altarpiece, the blue of the cloak, the clothes, everything is detailed. Everything is beautiful. Everything is so decorative for the period. So Gentile da Fabriano was a very innovative painter. Madonna of Humility is another masterpiece, is a symbol now, masterpiece that went to Fabriano for the great art exhibition in 2006, Mostra del Gentile, that was held in Fabriano at Art Gallery. This one is the catalog of the great art exhibitions. Polghetti Museum in Los Angeles keeps another masterpiece. Gentile made it for St. Francis Church in Fabriano, but now St. Francis in Fabriano, we don't have it because it was destroyed by earthquake in 19th century, and now you can see in that location our library. But this masterpiece, you can see the gold, you can see the coronation of the Virgin, you can see the dove, the bird, symbol of peace, above our above their heads. It's a masterpiece of Paul Getty Museum of Los Angeles. And this one is a typical face, the grace, the elegance of Gentile da Fabriano. Is a Madonna from Polyptych of Brera in Milan. After Gentile, we can find another important painter, Antonio da Fabriano, 15th century, San Hieronymus. Now he's in Baltimora, Walters Gallery. But Antonio da Fabriano was the most important painter after Gentile da Fabriano. And he uses a particular art, Flemish art, the Flemish art from Holland, the Flemish art from Belgium, because it was his great influence in the period that he worked in Genova and Naples, because he worked a lot in Genova and Naples. We have a masterpiece of Antonio Fabriano in Fabriano. Is Domitio Virginis is in the art gallery of Fabriano. There is the Pope that is reading St. Peter with the clothes of a Pope that is reading a funeral reading for the Virgin that is in the sky, and St. Thomas that holds a belt that connects the apostles to the Virgin. The Virgin is dead, but is going in the sky, in the paradise, and St. Peter is reading. You can see the pavement, the floor, more detailed in the Flemish style. In San Dominique, you can see also a important fresco of Antonio da Fabriano about Dominicans. It's a fresco, very, very large, and now there is the Museum of Paper and the Watermark, but you can see this beautiful fresco. Madonna and Child, Antonio Fabriano, you can see also the use of gold, the particular of face, is an art that had a lot of influences, as you know, and now this altar pipe is in Jenga. We have now an important period, 17th century, is Gentileschi. Gentileschi with a masterpiece of penitent Magdalene with the cloak, red cloak with an ointment, with the cross, the crucifixion, with the skull that represents the death, and so intense, so expressive of important master that was famous also for being the father of Artemisia Gentileschi. This masterpiece is at Oratory of Maddalena, Oratorio della Maddalena. The capture of Christ is part of important cycle of Orazio Gentileschi in San Venanzio Cathedral in Fabriano. You can see a typical art that had the influence from Caravaggio, but not only from Caravaggio, from other important artists, more classic in Rome. Orazio Gentileschi also is very important because will be the master, the painter of the court of France and England. So we can say that he is a European painter. Another detail with the angel of Gentileschi. And the crucifixion of Gentileschi, dark and the lights and the shades from a typical art, a mix, classic and Caravaggio. Salvatore Rosa is another great painter. San Salvatore Rosa in San Venanzio with the son Hieronymus. You can see the old man with the beard, with the lion, with a beautiful cloak, red cloak, in a cave that has the influence of the light of God, as very, very impressive, and the art of Naples, the art of Baroque of Naples, Giuseppe de Ribera Spagnoletto, is an important influence of Salvator Rosa, is in Fabriano, in the first chapel on the right in San Venanzio. Typical Baroque ceiling in San Venanzio. Frescoes of Filippo Bellini in Oratorio of Charity, Oratorio della Carità. You can see the influence from another great painter, Barocci, the art of Urbino, Renaissance. And maybe not so, it is a sense of a 17th century, the first years in the 17th century, it's an important cycle of mercy. San Nicolò has another great painter, Guercino, San Michele Arcangelo, San Michael, that is winning with the devil, is a great artist, classic, Baroque, and the 17th century. Is a masterpiece of the Church of San Nicolò in Fabriano. The beautiful Baroque of San Benedict in Fabriano. It's beautiful because it is also, this church represents an art gallery, Baroque art gallery. You can see a lot of masterpieces. One of these is Vanni in this beautiful Resurrection with the cloth, red cloth, that Tuscany paintings. And you can see also San Silvestro that is praying because this church is connected to the order of San Silvestro and Benedictus. This one is important painter of our territory is Giovanni Loreti. Loreti is 18th century, and this fresco of Coronation of Virgin is in the dome of the Cathedral of San Venanzio, and he worked a lot from another church in Fabriano, Sacro Cuore, Sacred Heart, Jesuits Order. Now we have to do a great step because we can explain important artists of 20th century as Mannucci, Edgardo Mannucci, that with his art very, very particular by using copper, zinc, metals, iron and fusion with the oxyhydrogen flame. He worked a lot, is very, very important for his status of energy, of fastness and the dynamic heart. You can see also the atom, glass atom, that represents the explosion of Hiroshima bomb and the energy in the space. This one is a spiral. But his work is with ideas, the name of his works, and you can see the material that is going in the space and also the explosion of material. And you can see now that the difference from the other one, that this one is a circle. Another idea is in the form of material in the space and the two atoms, two glass atoms, and a strange shape in shape of zigzag because it represents the material and the strength of the energy, the strength of the energy of this material. It's very important, this sculpture, because it was an important person of the School of Roma, the School of Roma movement of artists in Roma in 20th century. We have another artist, is Franco Giuli, that is in abstractism with shapes, lines, and so perspective, and uses an abstract kind of art. This one with the colors blue and red, you can see the shapes, you can see the dynamic aspect of his art. This one is without title, because you can see the shapes, you can see also the dimension, because he experimented a form of art, the third dimension, using cardboard, using wood, using sometimes other materials. Is very, very particular, but he had very success in Europe and in many art exhibitions. And now we are talking about Renzo Barbarossa. He's an artist that did a lot of kind of art, watercolors, and this one is the Fountain of San Dominic. It's very particular, and I like the reflection, the fountain with the light in this watercolor, a form of art of Renzo Barbarossa, very sensitive with his sensibility, his sensitivity. Postpone his art after other great artists. Another watercolor is a narrow street in a country, in a town, little town. But his art is also sculpture, beautiful sculpture of Giuseppe Verdi, the important musician from Parma, and it seems that it has a very particular, is similar to the art of Manzù, the art of Gemito in Naples, because it's very, very expressive, very intensive. Or this one with the two horses in a beautiful sculpture is art that I prefer of Renzo. Renzo Barbarossa is also a painter. This is a portrait of Romualdo Sassi. Romualdo Sassi, historical person, famous in Fabriano, that wrote a book of history of Fabriano. Ciro Bellucci, another artist, an artist of surrealism and enigmatic paintings. This one is Barn, the colors and the difference from the dark and the lights. There is a contrast, but very enigmatic. This one represents a date in a wood. And there is also a mystery. There is something that obscure, but you can find the light, but the beautiful aspect is very interesting aspect is the curiosity and also the mystery. The Charlant is another paint of Ciro Bellucci, surrealism, typical surrealism. Explosion of colors in Ciro Bellucci, red, yellow, and the dark in the background, always enigma. In his paintings. He lived in Belvedere in Fabriano, a nice small in the town in the countryside of Fabriano, but also he moved to Macerata when he worked a lot there. Guelfo is another important painter, is surrealism. We are 20th century surrealism. For example, in this angel, you can see his art. And he had a lot of contacts in Rome, relationship with artists as Giorgio De Chirico, with Marais, Cousteau, Chagall, Dalí. So he had a circle, intellectual circle of painters that is fundamental for his art. A typical aspect of art of of Guelfo, Surrealism in Fabriano. There is also a museum of his masterpiece and his works. Another artist, particular because he uses a mix of arts, is Franco Zingaretti, because Zingaretti, in particular for the use of different materials, for example iron, for example wood, and the sand of the river, or the sand of the beach, but in particular the river. There is a mixture that exalts in particular the archaic, the primitive aspects, with the symbols, with enigmatic figures, but also historic figures. He's an interesting painter, different from the other one, and he worked a lot with the marks of Maastricht tie. So he took from them the signs, the symbols. This one is the evolution of the man. The evolution of the man, and you can see also the colors, but the different materials that he mixed and combined in original art. The last thing that I would like to talk is the collection of Esther, House of Esther. I can see just two masterpieces, Manzu with the girl, the woman in the armchair, is all in bronze sculpture, and is a great collection in Fabriano of art contemporary and the art of 20th century. Particular collection that's inside in the art gallery. Manzu is one of the greatest sculptures of the 20th century in Italy and in Europe. And the horses of Giorgio De Chirico, typical art of Giorgio De Chirico, horses in the sand, the river, and the archaeological and the classical aspects that is the most important aspect of his art. This masterpiece is also in the Casa Esther in Fabriano in Art Gallery. So it was a pleasure to explain this long trip in the history of art, and I say to you good night, good evening, and enjoy watercolor events. Bye.